Hello everyone, I'm Dr. Priya Sipaha and today we are going to discuss a very common topic, that is public interest litigation, commonly known as PIL. This is a very, very important topic and this is most often used these days in a court. This is something related to the interest of the public, not for an individual. This is something which is necessary to understand. So basically, this is also something which is not stated anywhere in any act in India, but still it is a result of a judicial activism. So it is necessary to understand what exactly is the meaning of PIL, how it is filed, who can file, against whom it can be filed, what is the significance of PIL, and what is the drawback of PIL. So in this video, we are going to discuss all these things. So stay tuned. Now, what is PIL? Basically, public interest litigation is a term which is borrowed from American jurisprudence. And there it is designed to provide legal representation to previously unrepresented groups. And that unrepresented groups were like poor, the racial minorities, unorganized consumer, citizens who were passionate about the environmental issues, etc. And in India, public interest litigation is basically a litigation which can be filed in a court of law for the protection of any matter of public interest. Now, the thing which is important to understand is any matter related to public interest, not of personal interest. Now the difference is public interest could be the matter or issues related such as pollution, terrorism, road safety, constructional hazards, etc., in which a public at large is involved. For that, any PIL can be filed in the court. Now, as far as definition of PIL is considered, it has been not defined anywhere in any statute or act in India, but it has been interpreted by the judges to consider the intent of public at large. Similarly, it is also a power given to the public by courts only through judicial activism. So this is also very important, and this is something which can be filed by a citizen also, and then the action can be taken by the court, and it can only be filed in either High Court or the Supreme Court. This is also important to understand. So a person can also file a PIL, a group of a person can also file a PIL, and if a court thinks that these are some public interest issues which is important to be taken into consideration and which is not taken into consideration by the government, then a PIL or the suo motu action or a cognizance can be taken by the court also. So this is really a very important tool for the public interest. Now, what is the focus of PIL? Basically, there are four major things which is important to understand. If there is a violation of a basic human rights, then also PIL can be filed. Similarly, if there is any problem or any issues related to the content or conduct of government policy. Here, content is also important and conduct is also important. If there is any problem related to these, then also PIL can be filed. Then if there is any problem related to the compel municipal authorities to perform a public duty, then also PIL can be filed. Then if there is a violation of religious rights or other fundamental rights, then also PIL can be filed. Then what are the matters which can be entertained under PIL? Although I have already explained that what should be the focus. So the matters also related to that only, like if there is a problem related to the bonded labor matters, then there if there is problem of neglected child, then non-payment of minimum wages of workers and exploitation of casual workers, atrocity on women or a child, then environmental pollution and disturbance of ecological balance, then food adulteration, then maintenance of heritage and culture. Now you can look after these matter and you can easily understand that all these matters are related to the public interest. So these are the confined matter for which you can file an Now let's discuss the value of public interest litigation. Basically, it not only clarifies the law, but it also holds the accountability of the government body by ensuring that they are working and they are taking decision appropriately, they are acting fairly and transparently and with the remit of their powers. Similarly, they also help to develop the law by giving judges the opportunity to interpret legislation. Then they also give vulnerable people a voice by highlighting an important issues and providing a platform for advocating of their rights. And lastly, this also raise awareness of important issues, encouraging public debates and media coverage. Now the next important point is who can file a PIL and against whom a PIL can be filed. Now the important point is, as I have discussed in the previous slide also, that a PIL can be also filed or a suo motu action can be also taken by the courts. If a court think that there is a issue which is not taken consideration by the government, then the PIL or the issue can be raised by the court itself also. Other than it, any citizen can file a PIL in a form of a petition. So if they are filing a PIL in the Supreme Court, then it can be filed under Article 32 of the Indian Constitution. And if it is filed in the High Court, that under Article 226 of the Indian Constitution. Now the next question is against whom a PIL can be filed. Then the PIL can be filed against a state also and a central state or a central government also. Similarly, a PIL can be filed against the municipal authority also, but it cannot be filed against a private party because this is something related to the violation of the fundamental right, violation of the human rights and something related to the government. So that's why it can be filed against the state, the central government or any municipal authority. Now for that, it is important to understand that the definition of state is same which has been defined under Article 12 of the Constitution, which includes the governmental and the parliament of India and the government and the legislature of each of the states and all local or other authorities within the territory of India or under the control of the government of India. Now, next is very important that what are the steps for filing a PIL. So basically, first of all, who can file the PIL? A PIL can be filed by the common man also and by the advocate also. But it is always advisable that you must approach to an advocate who is having an experience of filing PIL because he is not only having an experience but the knowledge of all the details of law and also about the agencies against whom you are filing a PIL. Second thing is it also important to collect all the necessary documents related to the PIL. That means if you are having a problem related to the fundamental rights or the violation of the human rights or any municipal corporation or environmental policies or anything related to it, you have to collect all the documents, the necessary documents related to that particular things. Apart from it, it is also necessary to collect the list of the party or parties. Now, PIL can be filed not only by the single individual, but also by a group of a person. So, if there is a party or parties, then you have to collect all the necessary details of those parties. That means the name, address, and the other documents which is advised by your advocate. Similarly, you also have to collect the list of the agency or agencies. That means the government body against whom you are filing a PIL. So you have to collect all the necessary list of the agency related to it. Third thing is, again, you have to collect all the facts also. Previously, you have collected the documents related to the PIL. Here, all the facts. That means all the facts related with the violation of your rights and which is in the interest of the public. Then If you are filing a PIL in the High Court, it is necessary that you have to submit two copies of the PIL. And you must keep one copy with yourself also. Apart from it, before submitting two copies to the High Court or in the High Court, you have to also give copies to the concerned agency or agencies against whom you are filing a PIL. But if you are filing a PIL in the Supreme Court, then you have to submit five copies of the PIL. And for that, it is not necessary that you have to send those copies to the agencies before submitting that copies to the Supreme Court. Because Supreme Court, after looking after the PIL, and if Supreme Court thinks that the matter should be taken into consideration and it is an important matter, then by the suggestion or the order of the Supreme Court, you may then send to the copies of PIL to the agencies against whom you are filing a PIL. Now the next thing is a very important question, or the usually people ask the question whether the filing of PIL, whether it is very expensive. So it is not expensive. It's basically the court fees is 50 rupees per agency against whom you are filing a PIL, and apart from it, the fees of the advocate, that is necessary. But if you are filing a PIL with yourself only, that you are only a person who is filing a PIL, then definitely the fees will be less than you think. No matter, PIL is a very important tool in the hands of a common man for their interest. That means a public interest, but they are having some disadvantages also. First of all, PIL action may sometimes give rise to the problem of competing rights. That means, for instance, when a court orders the closure of polluted industry, the interest of the workmen and their families who are deprived of their livelihood may not be taken into consideration by the court. Secondly, it could lead to overburdening of court with frivolous PIL by parties and vested interest, not public interest. Because in current days, in the present scenario, the PIL is no more limited to the problems of the poor, but also related to corporate, political, and personal gains. The third point is that the PIL matters concerning the exploited and disadvantaged group are pending for many years. And because of that, because of the delay of that particular disposal of PIL, the cases may render many leading judgment merely of academic value. So these are some disadvantages of. So that is all about public interest litigation. I hope you like the video, and if you like it, do not forget to hit the like button and subscribe my channel. You may also follow us on various social media platforms by the name of Law Colloquy. We are also having our website, that is lawcolloquy.com, where we used to share legal blogs, legal news, articles, journals, case comments, videos, and many more things. And we also conduct many webinar, seminar, and various events related to law. So thank you for watching. See you soon. Bye bye. Take care.